according to a statement by the U.S. Space Command, or USSPACECOM, Russia successfully carried out a test for a missile capable of destroying satellites in low Earth orbit, LEO. General John W. J. Raymond, the commander of the U.S. SPACECOM and the U.S. Space Force Chief of Space Operations, explained in a statement that test utilized a direct-ascent anti-satellite DA-ASAT missile is capable of knocking out satellites. As per reports, Russia has leveraged the Nudol system for this. The anti-satellite weapon test raised concerns about the proliferation of military systems in space. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russia's direct-ascent anti-satellite Nudol missile is a major threat to the U.S. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Satellites are one of the most important assets for a nation. They play a vital role in civilian and military communications. Military satellites are used for gathering intelligence, as well as they can monitor and provide early warning against missile launches by a rival nation. Military satellites also provide guidance to missiles, aircraft, and warships, to name a few. So if satellites of a particular nation are destroyed, it will become handicapped in a conflict. This is why the anti-satellite weapon is seen as a key military capability by the world. The U.S. was the first to possess this kind of capability. The U.S. carried out its first ASAT test in 1959. The anti-satellite weapon had a range of 1,100 miles or 1,770 kilometers. A mock test was carried out in which a dummy attack on the Explorer 6, which was at an altitude of 156 miles, or 251 kilometers, was successfully executed. Relatively recently, in February 2008, it was reported that the United States Navy fired a Wyrm 161 Standard Missile 3 ABM as an anti-satellite weapon to take out a satellite which was operationally malfunctioning. The Soviet Union, after conducting a series of 7 tests from 1963 to 1971, declared its system operational in 1973. The weapon was designed to approach the target satellite, then detonate an explosive that would damage the target with shrapnel. In recent times, on the 18th of November 2015, Russia tested an anti-satellite missile, known as PL-19 Nudol, for the first time. The same missile was tested again in May 2016. In January 2007, China successfully destroyed a defunct Chinese weather satellite, FY-1C. As per reports, the mission was executed by an SC-19 ASAT missile with a kinetic kill warhead. FY-1C was a weather satellite orbiting Earth in polar orbit at an altitude of about 856 kilometers, or 537 miles, having a mass of about 750 kilograms, or 1,650 pounds. Its destruction created a lot of debris in space. In a national address last year, Indian Prime Minister Modi said India had achieved a historic feat by shooting down its own low-orbit satellite with a ground-launch missile in 3 minutes. So, as of now, there are only 4 countries, the United States, Russia, China, and India, that have demonstrated this kind of capability. U.S. Space Command General Raymond said the United States is ready and committed to deterring aggression and defending the nation, our allies and U.S. interests from hostile acts in space. Raymond emphasized, This test is further proof of Russia's hypocritical advocacy of outer space arms control proposals designed to restrict the capabilities of the United States, while clearly having no intention of halting their counter-space weapons programs. Space is critical to all nations and our way of life. The demands on space systems continue in this time of crisis, where global logistics, transportation, and communication are key to defeating the COVID-19 pandemic. Raymond said, "It is a shared interest and responsibility of all spacefaring nations to create safe, stable, and operationally sustainable conditions for space activities, including commercial, civil, and national security activities." U.S. officials have also expressed concerns about Russian co-orbital ASAT weapons. These are thought to be special satellites with the capability to change their orbits to approach adversary satellites. The U.S. SPACECOM statement also described past incidents of Russian satellites that exhibited characteristics of a space weapon by conducting close passes near a U.S. government satellite. Time magazine reported one such encounter in January when two Russian satellites, dubbed Cosmos 2542 and Cosmos 2543, drifted their orbits gradually closer to a U.S. classified imaging satellite operated by the National Reconnaissance Office. U.S. SPACECOM has described that incident as the type of behavior that would be seen as irresponsible and potentially threatening in any other domain. Russia had, almost every time, provided vague narratives and described their satellites in such incidents as inspector spacecraft conducting an experiment. A 235 PL-19 Nudol is a Russian anti-ballistic missile and anti-satellite weapon system in development. The primary purpose is to knock out rival satellites, and the secondary one is to deflect a nuclear attack on Moscow and industrial regions. It's important to note that these two missions share the same technological backbone. DA-ASAT weapon is designed to take out satellites in low Earth orbit traveling on an orbital plane, whereas an anti-ballistic missile interceptor is designed to knock out ballistic missile reentry vehicles in suborbital trajectories. The main developer of the system is JSC Concern VKO Almaz Anti. It's mobile and integrated with DON-2N radar and range radar DON-2NP, 5N-20P. The Nudol, when deployed, could be equipped with a nuclear warhead, which would greatly increase its ability to kill incoming warheads. The yield on which it will be deployed is not yet known. According to reports in early 2018, the system will not be equipped with nuclear warheads. March 2018, U.S. Defense Intelligence Agency Director Lieutenant General Robert Ashley, speaking to Russia's pursuit of these weapons, noted that Moscow would continue to pursue the development of a full range of ground, air, or space-based anti-satellite weapons as a means to reduce U.S. military effectiveness and control the escalation of conflict if deterrence fails. General Raymond described another incident in 2017 when a Russian satellite in orbit launched a second satellite. Raymond said of the incident, "The satellites exhibited characteristics of a weapon system when one of those satellites launched a high-speed projectile into space." Raymond has warned about the need for U.S. space assets to respond to both Russian and Chinese weapons advancements in space, including increasingly sophisticated lasers, anti-satellite weapons, and state-of-the-art spacecraft that could cripple U.S. space satellites. Brian Whedon, director of planning at the Secure World Foundation, told Space News that Russia's latest anti-satellite missile was a Nudol ballistic missile and that Russia put out a notice ahead of the launch. He said, "This appears to have been the 9th or 10th test of the Nudol system since 2014. So we know this system has been in development for a while." Experts from the nonprofit Secure World Foundation wrote earlier this month that evidence suggests the Russian Nudol system is being developed for the direct purpose of direct-ascent ASAT operations. The Secure World Foundation said in an assessment of global counterspace capabilities released earlier this month, "There is strong evidence that Russia has embarked on a set of programs over the last decade to regain many of its Cold War-era counterspace capabilities." So it's clear that Russia is developing a range of very sophisticated weapons designed to wage war in space, and the US needs to be very careful regarding this.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.